Good morning to all the class 5 students. This is your second video of chapter number 2, which is your animals living and surviving. Now we have to talk about on the basis of the food habits. In the previous video we have talked about animals has been classified into vertebrates and invertebrates, and on the basis of vertebrates the animals has been classified into 5 groups, and then invertebrates animals are those like which do not have a backbone like insects, worms, all those are the invertebrates animals. So now we have to talk about the animals on the basis of the food habits. They had been classified into how many categories, and on the basis of their adaptation, animals has been classified into migration terms and hibernation. That we have to talk. So let us begin. Ki on the basis of the food habits, animals has been classified into herbivorous, carnivorous, and omnivorous. So we can see ki on the basis of the food habits, animals has been classified into 3 categories, which is your herbivorous, carnivorous, and omnivorous animals. So herbivorous animals are those animals which eat only grass, green grasses they used to eat for their food purposes. So they are called as your herbivorous animals. Our carnivorous animals are those animals which depends upon the flesh of other animals. Or you can say ki carnivorous animals are the flesh eating animals. And omnivorous animals are those animals which eat both the grasses, vegetables you can say, and then flesh of the other animals are the omnivorous animals. So omnivorous animals are what? They are the plant eater as well as the flesh eater of the other animals. That is your omnivorous animals. Now we have to talk about what? Here on the basis of the adaptation habits, there is a two term called as your hibernation and migration. So let us look what is hibernation and what is migration of the animals. So hibernation of animals is what? The mass movement of the animals from one place to the another place in search of food or in order to escape from the harsh climate is called as your migration. And then I can give you an example, like Arctic terns are there. They used to migrate from one place to the other places. From Arctic Circle they used to migrate to the Antarctica Circle, and they used to come back to the Arctic Circle. These are examples what? In order to escape from the seasons, they used to migrate from Arctic Circle to the Antarctica Circles. And then Siberian cranes also, they used to come to India every year during the winter to breed. For the breeding purpose, Siberian cranes, they used to come to India for their breeding purposes every year. Then what is the next term is your hibernation. Hibernation means what? Hibernation is a state of the animals when they used to go to the deep sleep. Deep sleep means not the usual sleep we used to, when any kind of sound is produced, then you will move, they will do some activities, or even the human beings does some activities. This sleep does not relate to the hibernation. The hibernation term of sleep is that in this state, the animals, they used to go into the deep sleep for more than a month, or you can say more than a period. They used to go in a deep sleep for a long period of time in order to escape from the harsh climatic conditions like winter season, autumn season. Usually during this month, they used to go in the hibernation state. In this state, the animals, they used to go into the deep sleep when their body does not do any kind of activity. They will seem like they are almost in the dead state. So this kind of state is called as your hibernation state. Examples of the animals which goes into the hibernation state are what? Earthworm, snake, frog, bat, and squirrels. These are some of the animals which they used to go in a very long time of sleep. That is where they used to go under hibernation state in order to escape from the winter climate. And that means in order to escape from the cold climate, they used to go into the sleep, and they used to their body appears to be in the dead position, but they don't used to die. They are utilizing their fats which are stored inside their body for giving energy to their body during the sleep state. So this is what? This is the term called as your hibernation term, and migration is what? The mass movement, and hibernation is the state of deep sleep. So these are the two terms, and these are on the basis of adaptation, migration and hibernation are the two terms which is the last topic of your chapter. So with this, we have come to an end of chapter number 2. You watch the video, first video as well as the second video of chapter number 2 very carefully, and also read your book for good understanding of your chapter, so that you will be able to solve all the question and answer. Question and answer via PDF has been sent to you. You can copy it up from there, and then you watch the video twice and thrice to have a good knowledge of your chapter, and then you will have any kind of doubt relating to your chapter. Thank you.